Well, I don't want to waste time. We'll start when students join, can eventually join in. Is it clear? Well, start. What did we discuss in the last class? Students, wake up. Good afternoon. YP Pavan.
Yes, ma'am.
Did you go through the G codes? Did you go through the G codes?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am.
Gautam. Gautam. Go. Did you go through the G codes, Gautam? G codes and M codes. Dinesh. Dinesh. Now I've shared you with you all a Word file. Is it visible for you all? Boys, I want you all to respond. A Word file has been shared with you. Is it visible? Well, I want a response. I'm shared a Word file with you. Is it visible or not? Am I audible? Well, am I audible? Voice, can you hear me? YP Pavan?
Small.
I'm asking, can you hear me? So you don't want to answer for that?
That's fine. We can hear you, ma'am.
So I'm sharing a Word file. Can you all see that?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so in that I have clearly mentioned about the G codes, G00, X dimensions and Z dimensions. The format for writing G codes is being given here. For G00, G00 is rapid traverse, right? Similarly, I've given you in the last class we discussed the syntax for G01 also. You're giving the G01 command and we are giving X coordinate, Z coordinate and we are giving the feed. Right. Apart from that, I also spoke about G70 and 71. What is G70 and 71? When is G70 and 71 used? Boys, when do we use G70 and 71? Boys. Boys, when do we use G70 and 71? G71 is turning cycle, okay? G71 generates a rough turning. So for that, you give the path, you give G71, U will be the depth of cut, R will be the retrieval movement, right? And G71 is the command that we use for how many blocks, starting of the block till the end of the block. This instruction should repeat till when? From block numbers. PS to the end of the block, it repeats here. Then you give an allowance in X direction, you give allowance in Z direction, X direction, Z direction, and then you give the feed rate, right? So this is the format for rough turning, and this will be for finishing cycle. Finishing cycle, again the command will be the same. So it will be G70, start of the block, end of the clock, with clearance in X direction and Z direction. Is it clear? Shall we start with the programming now? Boys, in today's class, I want you all to know how to use G00, G01, and how to use G70 and G71. Is it clear? Is it clear, boys? Students, shall I move on? From next class, if you're doing like this, I'll ask you to switch on, everybody to switch on the camera. And I would like to hear your response from there. You want me to do that? So what are the commands we are discussing in today's class? Vidyan Prakash. Vidyan Prakash. G70 and 71. You're not discussing about G00 and G01? Ulas? Ulas? Srinivasalu? Srinivasalu? So those who don't respond, I'll not give attendance, I'm telling you. If you don't respond, I'm not going to give attendance. Srinivasalu? Kiranar? Kiranar? See, all those are not responding, I'm not going to give you attendance. Kiranar? I'm repeating again. Kiranar? Srinivasalu?
Hello, Spam.
What are the G codes we are discussing in today's class?
G70 and G71, ma'am.
Only G70 and G71? What about G00 and G01?
Yes, ma'am, G0.
What is G00? Well, for everybody, G00 is rapid traverse. G01 is linear interpolation. Now G71 will be rough turning cycle. G70 will be finishing cycle. Is it clear? So based on these commands, I'll be discussing in today's class. The first experiment for today's class will be shared now. See, this will be the first program. Write a manual part program for the part shown using CAN cycle. Is it clear? We're going to use the CAN cycle. In the last class only I discussed what is, I said up till here, this will be the standard format we use, right? So what is the standard format? Block numbers N05, N010, N015, N020. Why we are writing in the increments of 5? Can anybody answer? Why we are writing in the increments of 5? The block numbers. The end block numbers, why we are writing in the increments of 5? Gunasegar, why we are writing in the increments of 5? N block number 005, N block number 10, N block number 15, why we are writing in the increments of 5? Gautam Sai? Why are we writing the increments of 5? In case we have missed out any command to fit in there, so we are giving a gap width of in the increments of 5. Is it clear? Gap width of 5 we are giving. Okay. So next, if you see, block number N starts with the block number N05, then you have G21. G21 is nothing but metric unit. G99 is feet meet feet, which is given in feet for what? Meter, millimeters per revolution. Whenever we want millimeters per revolution, we give G 99. Then we go to the next statement, N 10, we give G 28. What is G 28? Boys, what is G 28? Now, if you're not answering, I'm going to wind up the class. You all only can continue with the class. Last class, I said, what is G 28? Boys, what is G 28? G28 will be returned to, automatic return to reference point. Is it clear? Automatic return to reference point. G28, the reference point, you're giving now values of x coordinate is 0, z coordinate is 0. Then you're going for N15, M06. What is M06? What is M06? Tool change, the tool change number will be T0101. Is it clear? Then you're going with N20, M03. M03 is spindle on, that is 1500. The speed of the spindle should be 1500. M07 will be coolant on. Is it clear? Then you're going with N25, G00, rapid traverse, and you're giving X56 and Z1. It's going somewhere, X56 and Z1 means the tool is being called here, right? Then from here, my programming starts. Boys, are you following? Are you following? Dinesh? Dinesh, Gunasagar.
Yes, ma'am. Noting down, ma'am.
Noting down. Yes. First, please take down the first few steps. I want you to take down the steps till here. Till here. Please take down the steps till here. This will be a standard format for any program you start. You have to give metric unit, you have to give feet, you have to give say automatic return to which home position, then tool change, then spindle speed setting, then we go for rapid traverse. Is it clear? We have noted down. Shall I go over the next G codes for the CAN cycle? Now, the format itself says that after the following the block number, you give G71, then U followed by 0.5. What does this 0.5 indicate? 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 Depth of cut. Very good. Depth of cut. Okay. Then you have depth of cut. After the depth of cut, you have given R1. What does R1 indicate? What does this R1 indicate? The retrieval moment. If it is going 0.1, then 1 mm it should be retrieved. Is it clear? If 0.5 it's taking the depth of cut, again to go back to the safe position, it should come 1 mm and then only go back. Are you clear? R is a retrieval value there. Then you have again, you are writing N35, G71. While you are writing the program, you can leave these values blank. P40. 2Q65, that means in this program I'm starting, the number codes that has to be repeated is from P40, means from this 40 to 65, up till this command it has to repeat for me. So I'm writing P40 to Q65 in the allowance of the x-axis 0.1, in the z-axis 0.1 with a feed rate of 0.2. Am I clear with this command? Are you clear with this command? Now I'm going to change the values and give you're supposed to write the program for this. That will be the task for today's class. What are you getting? How did we write G71? Block number followed by G71, you're going to give U will be given as a depth of cut, R will be the retrial amount given, then again the block number, P will be the starting of the block through which the motions has to follow, Q will be the end of the block, then you're going to give the X allowance number, then you're going to give Z allowance number, then give the feed value. Is it clear? Then, now I have to start writing my program. So first I have to call the program. So I will call next block number is N40. Then I'm calling G01. G01, I'm calling for X20 and Z0. That means I'm calling it here. So my first coordinate is X is 20, Z is 0. So first my tool is coming here. So I'm calling N40, G01, X20 and Z0. Next coordinate is here. What is this coordinate? It is X is 20, Z is minus 20. Is it clear? So X is 20, Z is minus 20. So I'm going to call the command, same command. G01, since it's moving linear interpolation only, next block will be N45, G01, X20, Z is minus 20. So my tool is here now. Next, to come back here, I have to call X will be 40, Z will be minus 20 itself. So you can see here, N50 is G01, X40, Z minus 20 here. Next again, I have to call the tool here. So it will be X40 itself. Z will be 20 plus 25. It will be Z minus 45. X40, Z is minus 45. So my tool is here. So next, if I have to go back here, so my tool will be X will be 60, Z will be 45. Next, if you see the block number N65, it will be G01, X will be 60, Z will be minus 75. So that is because 30 plus 25 is 55, 55 plus 20 is 75. So X is minus 75. So this command, the rough turning cycle, has to be repeated from P40 to 65. So this is your CAN cycle. Then you're going for N70. M05 is coolant off, spindle stop and coolant off. Then again, you're giving M75. You're asking the tool to go back to the home position, X0 and Z0. Then you're going to call the finishing operation. Before you start the finishing operation, you have to call for a tool change. So N80, M06 tool change, then tool number T020. That is the tool change. Then again, since you've changed the tool, again, you have to give spindles on. Then you have to give the spindle speed, that is in 2500 RPM. Then you have to call for the coolant on. The coolant will be on now. After the coolant is on, now next you're going to call the finishing cycle. Again, finishing cycle N90, G70. The codes for the tool has to do the finishing operation from here itself, 40 to 65. So I'm going to call again 40 to 65. But in the feed of here you gave feed as 0.2, but you can see the allowance given for feed will be 0.02. It will be very much less. So you have to make sure that you give the feed less feed here. Then again, go back to N95. Then you're going to call the coolant. You're going to stop the coolant, spindle stop. Then you're going to stop the coolant. Then you're going to ask it to go back to the home position since we're using G28. So the spindle will go back to the home position. Then you're going to stop the machine by calling M30. Is the program clear? Well, is the program clear? YP Pavan, is the program clear? YP Pavan, is the program clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Ulas? Now quickly, I want you all to copy the program because I am going to give a different values. For that, you have to write a program. Copy this standard program. For the different thing, I'm going to call a program. Is it clear? Copy it and let me know. Well, I'm asking your attendance. If you don't answer your attendance, I'm not giving you attendance. Daini Siddharth. Siddharth. Siddharth Sridhar. Subramania. Subramania. Sumukh VR. Tirumani set R. Ulas. Students, if you think of logging in and just moving around, it's not going to help you. There are so many failures in SimLab. Better take this lab very seriously. If you don't know the G code, if you don't know the programming, then you cannot do away with the SimLab. It's not a very easy task. You know, you need to know your basics. You need to have a sound knowledge on your basics. Mullahs, I'm marking you absent. Vidyan Prakash. Vidyan Prakash. Vibin Varun. YP Pavan. YP Pavan.
Present, ma'am.
Ranveer. Ranveer. Danushen. Yes, Vidyan, I've given you attendance. Danushen. Dinesh?
Yes, ma'am.
Now you can hear me, Dinesh.
Ma'am, some disturbance, so present to talk.
Now you better be attentive in my class.
Yes, ma'am.
Gunasagar?
Yes, ma'am.
Meghnata?
Ma'am, he went for exam, ma'am.
Okay. Prajwal? Prajwal R. Rasik. Rasik 405.
He went.
Shiv Krishna. Shreyas L. Shreyas L. Srinivasalu. Srinivasalu, if you don't answer your attendance, I'm not going to mark you. Srinivasalu. Yogananda. Kiran R.
Yes, ma'am.
You're being going to pay attentive in the class now. When I'm writing the course for the new program, you're going to help me. Is it clear?
Yes.
Shiv Pavan. Have you copied the program? Boys, I want to answer. Have you copied the program?
I haven't
okay,
called my name.
Okay, Gautam Sai. What's your USA number?
1BY16ME031.
Are you in this batch only?
Huh?
Are you in this batch only?
Yes, ma'am.
This is your first class?
No, ma'am, second class.
Okay, shall we go? Have you copied the program? Because I'm going to start the next program.
Yes, ma'am.
All of you have copied?
Copy.
Copying. How many are still copying? have some 11 chats. Yes, ma'am. Was done. Boys, if you are done, just let me know so that I need to change the slide. Done. Yes, ma'am. Okay, I'm changing it. Now, I'm going to draw Now this will be ten. This is 25. This will be 40. This is 20. Is the dimensioning clear? Why is the dimensioning clear? Dinesh, is the dimensioning clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now I want you to write the program for this. So what is this first coordinate over here? This will be x0, z0. What is this will be? X is 10, z is still 0. Okay, what is it here? X is 10, what is z? What is z?
25, ma'am.
25. What about this one? X will be 40. What is Z?
25 only, ma'am.
25. What about this one?
40 मैम.
40. What is x? 40 plus 25.
65.
65. Now what is this one? What is x?
80.
80. What is z?
65, ma'am.
65. What is this one? X is 80. Z will be?
85.
It will be 85. So when the problem is given, first job is to do is to mark the coordinates. Okay? After marking the coordinates, now we'll start writing the program. Can you tell me what are the first few lines that you have to follow for writing the program? I will use a text. First, what are the commands we'll use? Come on. N05, boys, make an attempt. Only then you will learn. N05. First, what I have to give?
G21.
N05. G21. What is G21? What is G21? It is to choose between metric or incremental, but we usually prefer metric, so we're giving G21. Is it here? Next, what is we have to give? G98 or
G99? 99,
ma'am. G99. Okay, because it is the feed to be given. So we're giving G99. Then next, what is the next command? N10. What was the standard command? This should be, you should be thorough with this. You should give an instance. Then next, what is the command we're going to write?
G28.
What is G28? What is G28? Automatic return to home position. That home position, I'm going to fix it as X0 and Z0. Okay. Next, what I have to give? N15. What is the next command I'll give? Since I have fixed my rapid travels to home position G28. Now I have to think of my tool. What is M06? What is M06?
Tool change.
I have to fix up my tool. So tool change. For that tool change, I'll give tool 101. You can give any number. Usually we give in 101, 102. So there will be a continuous use of tool. When you're using threading, drilling, grooving operations, then you can give 2E101, 102, 103. You can give, right? So we will think about it. Is it clear? Next, you have N20. So N20, what is N20? What is N20? Next, after
spindle.
That, what? Spindle on. What's the command for spindle on?
M03.
Then after that, we have to give?
Spindle speed.
What is the speed? You can fix between 1500 to 1000. I'm giving 1500. Okay. So spindle speed. Then after spindle speed on, what I have to give? M07. M07 or M08? What is for coolant on?
7, ma'am.
Coolant on is 7. Sure.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. It is coolant on. M07. Next. What is the command? N25. So what is the next command? After the coolant on, we're going to give rapid traverse. Still here will be the standard of N25. G00, you're going to give. Now what is the command where you want? We'll always fix for rapid traverse so that it goes away from the specimen, not make sure that it doesn't go and block the specimen. So I'm going to call it as X. I will call X. Since maximum is X is 80, now I'm going to call X 85. I'll call X 85. Why I'm giving 85 is it should go somewhere away from my tool. It should go here. So away from the specimen, right? So I'm going to call the tool somewhere here. So it should be more than X. X's standard value is 80. So I'm asking it to go for X 85. And I'm going to give Z, you can give 1. You all realize that if it goes this side, it is minus value. 1 means it's going this side. So Z is 1. So this is the safe position for rapid traverse. Is it clear? Is it clear? Did you understand why I have given x85 and z1 here? It should not come in contact with the specimen. So I know the maximum allowance in the z in the x direction is 80. So I'm giving 5 more increment. You can give any value above 80. So I can give 82 also. So x85 and z I'm giving 1. This side will be minus. So x1 means it's going on the other side of the axis. So it is z1. Is it clear? Somebody asked me a doubt. I hope I've not.
Ma'am, can you explain it again, ma'am?
Now see, I have fixed, I've done my prerequisite for writing my program. I've given G21, that is metric, then I've given feed, then I've given automatic to return to the home position for the tool also I've given, then I've given about the tool, spindle on to change the tool, then I've given the speed, I've given the spindle on, I've given the coolant on. After giving all these commands, I have to ask the tool to move now. So to ask the tool move, first I'm calling the G00 command. That's only for rapid traverse. Now G001, it should move in a safe position. Safe position without coming in contact with the specimen. Safe position, how to fix this dimension is maximum dimension of my workpiece is 80. Okay. So I have to give some amount excess. So I'm going to give x85. So that doesn't come in contact with the workpiece. So x coordinate will be x85. And I'm calling z1. Z1 is, if you realize, let me quickly type this N05 cheat quickly. Somebody G21, then G99, then N10, then it is G28, then it is X0. Set 0 automatic safe position, then it is N15, then it is N06, then you call in the tool TUN01, then you are going to give N20, then you have N20, then what is it? Now you have to call for the spindle on M03, then speed can be 1500, then you're going to start the coolant, then now N25. Now I'm going to ask for rapid traverse G00. This rapid traverse is to be the safe portion. So I'm going to call this Z is 85, but X maximum value is 80. So I'm going to give 5 value more. Anything above 80, you can take. So I'm taking here X 85 value and Z this side, if you realize it's all on the negative side. So I'm going to give Z plus 1, so that it does not come in contact with the tool when it is operating, when it is traversing. It should not come in contact with the workpiece. For a rapid, rough working, I'm moving, asking, making sure that the tool moves in the free space. Is it clear? Have I cleared your doubts?
Ma'am, in the previous problem, the maximum X was 60, ma'am. But in the code, we gave X 56, ma'am. It was less than the...
Maybe it was the... I have changed. Maybe the maximum X value, that is a small correction you have to do. Maybe X value was taken as 55.
Okay.
It is actually the highest value. More than the highest value you should take here. Okay. Next, I move on. Next, N30. What is N30 now? What will we be using? G01, first linear interpolation. So G01 means you can call first to X0, Z0. Is it clear? Are you following? I'm calling it first here. First linear interpolation, somewhere if it is here, means first it is coming here. Is it clear, boys? Boys, is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Shall I proceed? See, yes, we are asked to wind up the class by 2:30. For the coordinates, for the rough turning cycle, I'm going to write. You're going to write finishing cycle and post it in your Google Classroom. Only if you post the first record experiment where you have to get 15 for one experiment, only then I will give you 15 if you post it in today's classroom. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Otherwise, the first experiment will be considered as zero only. Is it clear? Now, quickly, can you tell me? Now, next N, 35, what is it? G01. G01, next it will be X10. Z will be again 0. Next, N, 40, G. Oh, we have not given G71 only. Without using the Cahn cycle, why we are writing this? Nobody told me about this. What is U? U should follow with the depth of cut. R will be retrial motion. Then again, N30G71. Now, what is P block? P, I don't know. I will fix my command. It is P should be 35. I know the start of the block, so I will write it as P35. I don't know the Q value. Q value, I'm going to leave it as it is. And I'm going to write allowance in U should be 0.1 and allowance in W should be 0.1. Okay, then the feed I'm giving it as 0.2. So this will be the command. Okay, so now P is 35, G0 is X85, Z1, then 35, no, sorry, 40. This is 40, this is 45, X10, Z0. Now next, G01. What is it, X now? It is here, now it should go here. Now it is, X is still 10. What is the value of Z now? What is the value of Z? 25. What is the value of X now?
40.
X is 40. What is Z value?
25.
Z is 25. Next, N 50. What is the value of X now? X is still 40. What is the value of Z?
65.
And one more mistake I have done is all these Z values are minus. Okay.
Ma'am, you have written N40 and N45 double time, ma'am.
Oh, sorry. N40, 45, this should be 50. This will be 55. This will be 60. This will be 65. Now it's correct.
Yes, ma'am.
G01. Now next, what is the X value now? X is 80. Correct now? X is 80. What is the value of Z now? Minus 65 only. Then, N is 70. G01. What's the command for X? X will be... What is X? 80. Z is minus 85. Now again, stop the coolant, stop the spindle, change the tool. All those commands have to come here. What are those commands? Can somebody quickly tell me? M05 and M09. NAP, M05 and M09. Coolant turn off and spindle stop. And again, it should do the go back to the automatic return to the home position. But N will be 85. N will be 85. So this is how I have done for rough cycle. Now I want you to do for finishing cycle and post it. Is it clear? Boys, is it clear? Boys, today is the engineer's day, so there is some program at 2:30. We are asked to wind up the classes by 2:30. I want a response. Will you write for the finishing cycle and post? The Google Classroom? Vidyan says yes. What about others? Yes.
Ma'am, can you show the code for finishing cycle, ma'am, of the previous problem?
Finishing cycle. You want to see the format?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Once again. Can you see it? It is the same. For the finishing cycle, it is G70, PS, QC, NC, and WC. For the rough cycle, you have already returned. So you don't have to think much. You just have to put this command and enter the block numbers, give the allowance for X, give the allowance for Z, and finish it. But the thing is, you should have changed the tool previously. Now, given G28, right? After G28, you're going to again change the tool. Give the M06, give the tool change. Shall I write it here? Is the paint visible to you?
Yes, ma'am.
So now again, you will give N90, you will give M06, that is the tool change. I've given T101 in the first place, but you give T102, tool change. Now after tool change, again, what you have to do, you have to again give, you will give N100, okay? Now we have to ask the spindle to run
N95, ma'am.
Oh, sorry, N95. Then it will have spindle on. Then you give the speed. Speed should be less, so I'm going to give 1000. Then I'm going to on the coolant as well, M07. Now the finishing cycle, that it be G70, okay? So it is N100, okay. Now what is G70? I have to give G70. Now again, only the codes. Which are the codes? Code block is, it has to repeat till G70. So I'm going to give block number till 70 here. Now it will give do the finishing cycle from P35 to Q70 with an allowance of U of 0.1 value and Z also of W of also of 0.1 value, and feed should be 0.002. Here the feed rate should be very minimum. This feed rate, if you compare this feed rate and this feed rate, must be much lesser. And you're going to repeat this step again. After this, it will again be NAT, spindle off, and coolant off. This will be a command. Is it clear? Are you following it now? You're understanding how to write the program? Today is the last class. From next class, I will give the syntax for each command and I will show you the simulation in the system, the SimLab software. I'm taking so much pain so that you understand the programming. Programming is very important because without programming, you cannot move forward. That's why I'm taking two classes. Last class, because of the connectivity, I couldn't do much. But today, make sure you learn the programming perfect. Till here will be the standard commands. Then G71, since we're using CAN cycle, you're going to give here. Then you have to make based on putting the coordinates. You're going for linear interpolation, you're going to use G01. If you have circular interpolation, you're going to use G02 and write the commands. Then you're doing the finishing cycle. Suppose if you have threading cycle, you'll add the threading cycle. Suppose if you have grooving, then you'll add the grooving. But this is the basic. If you have not understood this, then we cannot move forward. Is it clear? So in today's class, for this, you can take a pic of this, okay? And you're going to write a programming. See, I'm drawing with the help of paint, so my sketch is looking so bad, but I want you to use clean sheets and pen and draw it neatly and post it in the Google Classroom. Am I clear? Only then for the first experiment, you'll be getting full marks. Boys, this will be used as a scheme for valuing your first experiment. Is it clear? Shall I wind up? Boys, am I clear? Okay then. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.